Morning, guys. So it's actually like 1 o'clock. My hair is super freaking staticky. You guys see this? It's driving me crazy, but I need to run a few errands. I need to go to Target. Okay, sorry. My hair is literally driving me insane and my face is super swollen and I can't find a good angle, so we're just gonna go with it. But I need to go to Target. I need to grab this little cart thing that I'm gonna put beside my bed, and it's also gonna be like a little like wheelie station for my pump stuff. So while the kids are gone, Graham has the kids today. He's gonna have them for the next couple days. So yesterday I deep cleaned the whole house. All the kids were out. Everly was with her dad, and the kids were with Graham. He like took them for a little bit, I think to the gym or something. But and Audra was out and about running errands, so I took that time to clean the whole entire house. I deep cleaned from top to bottom. So basically today is just getting the last minute things that I need for the baby. So I'm getting that cart thing. I'm also gonna be picking up some like ingredients for this like midwife's brew. I saw that Brittany from Brittany and Baby, she tried this out. I don't know if I'm gonna take it today, just because I really like, I don't know if I want to go into labor yet. I don't know if I'm ready. I don't know if I'm ready for all that. So I think I'm just gonna buy everything, and then like when I feel like I'm ready, I'll get it. I'll be 39 weeks tomorrow, so I'll technically be full term tomorrow. So probably not gonna try it. I don't know. I'm really scared. One, I've never tried castor oil because I've been so scared that I'll like literally shit my brains out. So kinda nervous about that. But anyways, we're gonna go to Target, pick up that stuff, and then get the rest of my baby stuff done that I need to get done. Okay, we have made it to Target. Ugh, goodness gracious. Too pregnant for this.
Look how cute this bag is. It's 50 bucks, so I'm not gonna get it, but this would be so cute to travel with, or as like a hospital bag. If you guys are having a baby soon, you guys should get it. Also, look at that suitcase, it's so cute. This is at Target. I'm obsessed with this line. I think it's Jungalo. Yeah, Jungalo. So cute. Okay, picked up the cart, that's what it looks like. Also got a curtain rod, it was like $6.88, and some candy. Just because I like to suck on hard candy during labor. So that was really awkward. People were coming by, but got it, check. Let's go home. Stopped to get some panda. I also forgot to get the stuff for that drink. So I'm gonna stop at Walmart. It's like right by me. Stop there, get the stuff I need, and then head home. So just got done eating panda, and honestly don't know if I should even go into Walmart to get that stuff because I'm having contractions. Ugh, let me set you down. I'm having contractions and they're hurting, so I don't know if I should even go in and get that because like what if I'm in freaking labor. Ugh, they're more so just like really uncomfortable and like taking my breath away, but it's not really hurt. So I don't know if I should go into Walmart or not. I mean, I might as well just go pick the stuff up. Does Walmart even have castor oil? I don't even feel like walking. I don't even feel like doing anything. Ugh. I'm tired. I don't feel like driving. I'm so tired. Literally, like, putting my makeup on and getting out of the house is exhausting. I still have so much to do at home. All right, I'm gonna just go to Walmart really fast. It's literally maybe 150 yards away. Let's go. I'm so tired. There you go. You guys like that angle?
Did you like that angle? Okay, this is gonna be a quick in and out trip, so I'll see you guys when I get back. And we're back. Oh, that took so much longer than I was expecting. Let me do a quick little haul for you guys. Okay, so the recipe or cocktail or whatever called for lemon verbena, I wanna say. It called for lemon verbena or verbena. Lemon verbena tea. So they said that this would work, the Tazo Zen tea. So got this. Also got creamy almond butter. The recipe called for just 2 tablespoons of almond butter, so got that. And then it called for apricot juice, but I thought that pineapple juice might work because I could not find apricot juice anywhere in this freaking Walmart. Should have looked at Target. I figured pineapple, they say pineapple juice will make you go into labor, so I just got the pineapple juice, and then I looked it up and they said that pineapple juice, I guess, could be a substitute. So I just got this 100% pineapple juice. And then I got this castor oil. I'm really nervous to try this. It's only like 2 tablespoons, so it's really not that much. But like, I'm still hella nervous to try this. So if I end up posting this, I've probably already taken it. So don't leave your comments down below telling me not to take it. I really don't want to hear you guys' opinions on what happened. So I guess by the time this is posted, you guys will know if I went into labor or not. Graham told me to go ahead and do it tonight because he has the next like 3 or 4 days off. So that would be like kind of perfect because then he wouldn't have to go into work and then he would be able to help me. So I'm super nervous. If this works, I'm sure you guys will already know. So did it make me go into labor? Guess we'll find out. Let's go home. I need to set up all of my postpartum stuff and get my breasts area, my breast pumping area set up, and get all that ready before I try this drink. And you have to try it on an empty stomach, and I just ate panda. So that wouldn't, I can't really take it right now anyway. So gonna do this, clean up the house, get everything all ready and feel prepared. I should have a few Amazon packages coming in the mail for the baby's bag. So I'll show you guys what I got for that. There is like a few more things that I ordered that I don't think are gonna be here in time if this actually does put me into labor. It was like some hospital hat that was supposed to come. That's not supposed to come for a few more days. So depending on when it comes, if I'm in the hospital or not, maybe it'll deliver and then Graham can bring it to me. I live a little bit further away from the hospital this time around than I used to. So I'm kind of unpacking a lot because I can't come back and just grab something if I need, or Graham couldn't just come back and grab something because I do live kind of far away from the hospital. And also, I was at the hospital for 6 days, 5 nights with Wolf because he was in the NICU for low blood sugar. So I'm preparing myself for a NICU stay because I did not pack enough with Wolf. If I would have just stayed the 2 nights or whatever, or 3 nights, I think I would have been okay. I was running low a little bit, but I've definitely overpacked this time around. But I don't think I'll be overpacking if we have to end up staying for a NICU stay. So I'd rather overpack just so that I don't have to make Graham come all the way back out to where I live. But we're heading home and whew, your girl's out of breath. So let's go. Okay, so I'm back home. I'm not sure what the last thing that I vlogged was, but I have all of my like postpartum stuff right here. I have all the pads. No, these are, yeah, some of these are pads and then some of them are the disposable nursing pads that I had with Wolf. Sorry if my sucker is like kind of gross, but let me just set it down. Okay, so all of these are my pads and then disposable nursing pads that I had with Wolf that I don't like, but I will keep them in there in case I need them for like a quick little fix. You guys will see what I'm doing, but basically, I think I saw this on Shannon Rose's video. It was a while ago when she was pregnant with Snow, but got freaking toothpaste on this. But anyways, I got a clear over the door organizer. It's gonna go on the back of my bathroom door. I'll show you guys where. And then I have a whole bunch of leftover stuff from Wolf. So I have a whole bunch of mesh underwear left over. I have Dermaplast left over, 2 cans of that. I'm gonna end up getting more, but I'm gonna go ahead and put this in there just to start off with. I have a Perry bottle. I have only 1 ice pack. I'm gonna have to steal some more of them, girl. These are freaking amazing. By the way, if you guys are wondering like what I get from the hospital, basically all of this is from the hospital. Obviously not this, and obviously
not the disposable nursing pads, but these pads are what I got in the hospital. Everyone says they got like really huge pads. I didn't. I got these ones. Let me show you.
These are the ones I got in the hospital. I mean, I don't care if I open these just because why? Because I'm getting more. But these are the ones that I got in the hospital. But then I got these ice packs, which I'm not gonna completely open up because I could use this afterwards. But basically what this thing is freaking huge. And it's basically like a big pad. And all you have to do is like snap it, and then it turns into an ice pack. So it's like it's already like those padsicles, except you don't need to like keep them frozen. They'll just kind of cool off for you. They're the best things ever. I'm not sure. Yeah, you just break it in half, shake it like this, and then you just put it in your pad or whatever. So I'll show you guys what I do. I normally lay this down in my underwear, but I actually don't really like these pads. I would recommend these pads, but I'm obviously gonna use these up if I can. So I have these. I like wings on mine, so that's why I just prefer these. So that way they stay in my underwear a little better. But I'll lay this down, put this down, and while I'm changing out my pad, I'll warm this up with hot water from the sink, and then I will spray. So one thing that I am purchasing, I'm so excited about, is this fridge right here. It's like a fridge slash heater. So I'm gonna keep that by my, what's it called? That little cart that I bought. And so it can heat up and it can also be a fridge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep a Perry bottle in there filled with warm freaking water. So that way I can just come in my room, open up the little fridge type warmer thing, grab it and go. So that way I don't have to like sit there, come in here, fill it up. Especially afterwards, I'm gonna be so sore. It'll just be easy. Just go in there and grab this. And then at nighttime, I can use that little fridge to keep my breast milk cool. So I don't have to go to the kitchen. Isn't that amazing? So I'll have it linked down below if you guys are curious in that. I'm gonna be setting that up. I need to order it off Amazon. It's only $40. So I'm gonna get that. But anyways, while I'm doing my like pad changing, I will grab this with warm water and I will, you know, rinse down there, you know, get all, that's the best part. Honestly, this is the best part, rinsing. Then while I'm changing out my pad, I've done my little squirt while I'm peeing so it dilutes the pee. I will spray a little bit more just to kind of like soothe the area. Then I will kind of sit there, let it dry a little, and then I will spray on my Dermaplast, which is right here. Spray that on, and then I'll spray on my Mama bottom spray, which is in my hospital bag, or I'd grab it. I'd spray that on top of that. And then I would put 1, 2, 3 of these pads. They're basically like Tux pads. They're not the actual Tux pads. These are called Witch Hazel. I don't know, they're the hospital brand kind, but they're just pre-moistened Witch Hazel pads. Basically Tux pads. So you will get this at the hospital. If not, you can go to the store and buy it. But I got all this at the hospital. So I'll put 1, 2, 3 down like this, layered on my little ice pack. And then I will grab one more of these and place it directly on my vagina, right where my child popped out. And it is the best feeling ever. I'll pull this up in the ice pack and the Tux pads feel amazing. I am thinking about buying this perineal balm from Earth Mama, I think is what it's called, and I heard that's really nice too. So I might try adding that into my little routine, so if you guys are curious, I'll let you know how I like it. But yeah, basically, that's what I do. If you guys were wondering, here, I'll give you a close-up shot.
That's how I layer them, I guess. 1, 2, 3. And then there's gonna be one more that goes directly on my vajayjay.
But I do it that way because I feel like you just make sure you're getting the whole entire area rather than just like putting one down. You will go through these super fast. I would just ask for a hell of a lot. I didn't run out with Wolf, and I think I grabbed like 2 of these, and
a bunch of ice packs. I think I grabbed like, oh, so many. Just ask for more. Your nurses, they'll give you more. You're basically paying for it, or insurance or whatever. They charge you, but it's free, you know? It's free, girl, so ask for it. They will get it for you. It's their job and they don't care. They wanna help you. So anyways, I'm gonna set all this up and then I'll show you guys what it ends up looking like. Okay guys, so this is what my door looks like. I guess my bathroom door, toilet room door, that looks like coming from my bathroom. So there's my shower. So because this room is so small, that is why I didn't do like a basket like a lot of people do. They keep a basket in their bathroom, but this is so tiny and I didn't really want to put anything back there because I didn't want to have to be like turning around while I'm like on the toilet and stuff. So because this room is so small, here is what it looks like with the door open. Like, it's tiny. So when you're in here, this is how it's going to be set up. So the toilet's going to be right there, and then I can just reach and grab on the back of here everything that I need. So those two spots up there are empty, but I would probably be putting like extra regular underwear once I can like get into my underwear in case I have like any stains from like blood or anything. And then I might put like some nipple butter, and then I don't know, stuff that I'm not gonna be reaching for, I guess, as often. This little pocket right here has those disposable nursing pads, and I'll probably be keeping my regular nursing pads in here somewhere, not sure, but they're all packed away in my hospital bag right now, so those will come in here. And then I just have those pads that I'll probably use up right when I get home, and then I'll go on to these pads, but I just have those in there, and I have way more disposable nursing pads, so once those are all used up, I'll probably just fill that whole thing with. Then down here, I just have the mesh underwear. I'm gonna be getting way more of these, and there's plenty of room in here for more, so that's where the mesh underwear is gonna be. And then I have, I guess, this is my most satisfying row, just pads. So I have my thinner pads for once. I'm maybe like 2 weeks postpartum that I can probably start using these for. And those have the wings. And then I have, obviously, my maxi pads. I'm gonna be going through these like crazy. So I have the extras underneath my like sink vanity area. So I'll just like be refilling those as I need them. I have my Dermaplast right here. I'll be getting more, so I go through these pretty fast. And whew, I'm out of breath. And I'll also be keeping my Mama Bottom spray in here, and probably the perineal like a balm. If I end up getting that, it'll go in this little space too. Then I have my Tux pads, my peri bottle, because I know I'll be getting an extra one with this new baby, so I'll probably just keep that in there filled with regular water in case I need to just have some type of water or forget to grab the bottle from the little warmer. So I'll just keep that in here filled with like regular water. I fill it up with warm water, but any type of water will help, so I'll just probably fill that up with water. And then down there I have my ice packs, which I'm gonna hopefully fill to the brim, girl. So yeah, that is how it looks, and I really like this idea, so that's how I'm gonna be organizing everything. With Wolf, I had a basket like underneath my like sink area, and it did the job, but it did suck having to bend over and grab everything. So I think that'll be really nice that I can just already be on the toilet and just grab what I need from that. That's that. Now I'm gonna put the cart together and get that all put together. Probably not gonna vlog that, but I'll show you guys what that looks like once it's all put together and everything's on it. Don't mind my not made up bed, but here is the little station over here. So this is what it's looking like. I just have my little diaper caddy, and I just have some diapers and wipes, some burp cloths, I have some pacifiers, just a few extra changes of clothes, and then what I use to like wipe the booties when they're like really tiny, like when they're newborns, because their skin is so sensitive. So I just have some of that stuff right there. Down here I just have all of my extra pump parts and a few disposable nursing pads that I freaking hate, but I have them just in case, because the ones that I normally use are in my hospital bag. So just have that, and then extra like just like nursing stuff, like
heating pads and Soothe gel pad thingies. And sorry if you guys can hear American Sniper in the background. Graham's watching it. But, and then down here, I just have some blankets down there. Two swaddles, one a bigger blanket, and then my pump. So that's what that ended up looking like. So basically, everything is ready for the baby. Have the rock and play right here. I'll be sleeping right there. And that is everything. So the kids are sleeping right now. So sorry that they weren't in this vlog, but I was like away from them pretty much all day. It was Graham's day, but he's kind of been like around a lot, so they're staying here. But anyways, I have everything packed, ready to go. I think tomorrow I'm gonna film what's in baby's hospital bag. But basically, everything is all ready. I got everything that I needed to get done. I got done. So, getting excited. I might end up trying that drink. I don't know. I'm kind of nervous. But that's why I wanted to get everything done before I end up even trying the drink. The only thing left that I have to do is change the sheets on my bed. I want to put on fresh, clean sheets. That way, if the baby's like in the bed, it's not like on laying on like dirty sheets. But yeah, that's basically everything. So that's going to be the end of this vlog. This was probably a super long vlog. I'm sorry, but I'm so tired. I'm going to go out there, spend some time with Graham, watch a movie, I think, and then go to bed. Okay, guys, so it's currently 1:24, and I have everything that I need to make, not including that, for this concoction. It's called a cocktail or whatever. Kind of super nervous, kind of worried about making this, not gonna lie, but I'm just gonna go for it. So the recipe calls for 10 ounces of apricot juice. And then the tea, 2 tablespoons of almond butter. Okay, 2 tablespoons of almond butter. Can you watch that? It's about to boil over. I'm already having contractions. I don't know if this is a good idea. And I'm already shitting like every 5 minutes. Two tablespoons of castor oil. Oh my god, I'm so nervous.
Why?
Because the castor oil.
What's that? What is it?
It's a laxative.
Oh, you gotta be shitting.
No, that's why the almond butter is in there, apparently.
Yeah,
1. Yes, I have ramen noodles.
Where are they?
In the pantry. Okay, here we go. Now this has to steep for, let's see how long. Okay, the tea bag has to sit for 10 minutes. So let's set a timer for 10 minutes. And I will come back once it's all ready. Okay, guys. I'm not ready for this. I'm literally so nervous. Let's try and get the edges. Okay, maybe not. Okay, I'm so nervous. How does this work?
Other way. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, it's so loud. I hate you.
Yikes. Okay, I feel like I need to drink it out of a straw. Like,
get a straw.
Not see it.
Close your eyes.
Soak it up.
Oh, I'm so nervous.
Shut up.
You're not the one drinking it.
Dishes.
Ew.
Some chunky and nasty.
Cramp, shut up.
Put this in.
No, because I'm going to have to drink the rest of that, I think.
It's gross.
It's not that bad.
Can I try it? JK, I'm not fucking drinking that shit.
It's not that bad.
You gotta chug it. 10-second chug.
I have to.
10-second chug.
Ew, gross.
Chug it. Chug it. Your battery's about to die.
I know.
So you gotta chug it fast.
It's like kind of warm.
There you go.
I'm about to puke.
That's gross. If you puke, it's gonna be great. Chug it. 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 I want you to throw up so bad.
I can't chug.
Chug it, dude.
It would taste better over ice. I don't have ice. Graham, stop. Well, guys, we're on the way to the hospital.